Romans chapter 8, verse 29. Go ahead.
For whom he did foreknew.
For whom he did foreknew.
He also did predestined.
He did also what? Predestined.
To be conformed to the image of his son.
To be conformed to the image of his son.
That he might be the firstborn among many brethren.
Continue.
Moreover, whom he did predestinate, them he also called. And whom he called, them he also justified. And whom he justified, them he also glorified. What shall we say then to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us?
Okay. Go back to 29 and read from there again.
For whom he did foreknow, he also did predestinate.
Right.
To be conformed to the image of his son.
Right.
That he might be the firstborn among many brethren.
Right.
Moreover, whom he did predestinate, them he also called. And whom he called, them he also justified.
Right.
And whom he justified, them he also glorified. What shall we then say to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us?
All right. Now, tonight, I'm going to be teaching you what I titled, How to Fulfill Your Prophetic Destiny. Say amen. Everybody born again have a destiny in God. Now, the destiny in God is your responsibility to fulfill it, to make it happen. But in the sight of God, God has done his own already. So it's in my own sight that I will do what I got to do to fulfill it. I welcome all our viewers, any part of the world, into tonight's service. And I'm believing God as you connect any part of the world. The Spirit of the living God will open your understanding so that you will fulfill your destiny. You will be the man, the woman God has destined to be. Receive the understanding in Jesus' name. And then help us share it. Let's let people know that God is speaking the word of God now. Because when you do it, God will reward you. Let's share it quickly. Let's help people understand this so that you can get the reward as we share it. Everybody repeat after me. Say, I have destiny. Shout and say, I have destiny in God. And my destiny is already settled. And whatever God has destined for me, that's who I'm going to be. So what does the word destiny mean? The destiny is not talking about your past. Destiny is talking about what? Your future. If God say you are destined to be rich, he mean you are what? Destined to be what? Rich. If God say you are destined to be great in life, he mean what? You are destined to be what? Great in life. That's exactly what God mean. So I'm praying that whatever happen, you will cooperate with God and you will fulfill your destiny in Jesus' name. Because anything God said it, he meant it. Anything God say, it will come to pass. So now let's go back to the scripture again. In the book of Romans chapter 8, verse 29, let's go back there. He said, for whom he did what? For no, he also did what? Predestined to be conformed to the image of his son, that he might be firstborn among many brethren. So here the Bible is saying that for whom go for no, that means God the same yesterday, today, what? And forever. That means God know your future. Before you were born. God know what you're going to be in life before your mother conceived you. God know everything you're going to go through in life before you get into this world. So that means God does not make a mistake. Everything you're going to be, God know you're going to be. So if you don't be what you're supposed to be, it's not because God does not want you to be. It's because well, somehow you do not understand how it works. But today, through the teaching of the word, you're going to understand that you are destined to be great in life. I say you are destined to be great in life. You are destined to be rich in life. That is the will. That is the purpose. That is the intention of God. And then I'm going to guide you through the world. So that you understand. Everyone say, God knows my future. Everything I'm going to be in life, God has already destined me to be. And by the Spirit of God, I will get to that place and nothing can stop me. So Holy Spirit, help me to cooperate with you so that I can get to that place I'm supposed to go. Now, it's like this. If somebody invites you to come to their house or go somewhere, what would they do? They will send you an address.
Yes, yes.
Yes, yes. Yes, yes. The purpose of the address is to tell you, this is where you will meet me. But see, when you have an address, it does not mean you're going to get there. So what are you supposed to do? Is to take the address, give it to you, and put it to a navigator. Right? And it's and then the navigator will begin to lead you into where you're supposed to be. But can I tell you one thing? For the fact that you have the address, it does not guarantee you get there. I don't think you understand. Let me explain. I know where I'm going. I have the address. But the problem is that even though I have it, it's how to get there that is important. So I know where I'm going, but what route do I take to go there? Yes, yes. Now, I can walk to get there. I can drive to get there. I can take aeroplane to get there. But see, the person that takes aeroplane can get there faster. The person that takes a car can get there faster. The person that takes motorbike can get there faster than the person who has done walk. So how do you get there? That means it's my choice to go by plane. It's my choice to go by a car. It's my choice to go by a motorbike. It's my choice also what to go by leg. But let me ask you a question. Who will get there faster? Who will get there faster? Can we talk? Who will get there faster? Aeroplane, right? Now, let's because I want to teach you, that's why I want to get you involved. Have you realized that some people get richer at the age of 30, but some people get richer at the age of 70? Hello, talk to me. Does it mean God love the person at the age of 30 more? No. Yesterday, I was watching a young boy at the age of, David, listen to me, at the age of 9, he's a professor. Yes, it's on YouTube. 9 years old. He's what? A professor. In mathematics, physics, chemistry. An Indian guy, you saw it, right? 9 years old. Professor. Do you get a point now? Now, people have to sit down to listen to him. You get a point now? People have to sit down to listen to him. But there are people who are 50 or 70, they have not even finished the university. Hello, talk to me. At 9 years old, you're a professor. They taught him. They couldn't, no class could hold him. No class. He can't, the teacher, he can teach the teacher. So now, they take him around, give him a little, go around the world to give, they even give an award. What am I telling you? In destiny, God is very fair. But how you're going to get to your destination is tied to what you do. Even though God has destined you to be somebody in life, God has destined you to be somebody, but you can't get there by coincidence. You have to get there by strategy or planning, by strategy doing what you're supposed to get there. But even though in destiny, you're already there, but you are still behind. So what will I do to get me to where I'm supposed to go? Because in this scripture, it says, for whom God did what? For no, that means God knows about me. He also what? Dit toi predestiné, pre. The word pre is the word before. He predestined me to be conformed to the image of his son, that he may be the firstborn among all. So that may God know about me before I am here. So the speed I have in life is not tied to God. The speed I have in life is tied to me. How fast I will get to my prophetic destiny is tied to me, not to God. I've been destined to be somebody. I've been destined to get married. I've been destined to have a car. I've been destined to become somebody in life. Yeah, that is a fact. That's the truth. But how can I get there? That is tied to me. It's my prayer that you will get there fast. I say you will get there faster than you ever know. I say you get there faster than you ever know. So you decide how fast you want to get there. You decide how quick you want to get there. Say any form of delay. Say any form of delay. I take it out of my life. In the name of Jesus. Whatever will delay me from getting to my prophetic destiny, I reject it now in the name of Jesus. Some of you are afraid. I want us to pray a prayer briefly, because some of you are going to get there when you are 90. I don't think that's the way. Say in the name of Jesus. Anything that will block me, anything that will hinder me from getting there very fast, I remove it right now in the name of Jesus. Say, I remove it right now in the beginning.
Pray for your destiny.
You don't want to go there at 90. Pray for your destiny. You don't want to go there at 70. Pray for your prophetic destiny. Pray for your destiny.
Now is the time.
God has destined you, but you will decide.
Now is the time.
I will not be delayed. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Jesus.
And have your seat. Cast your prayer, Kadaba. So, as I say, I want to teach you. I'm going to help you understand scripture so that you get there. Say, in the name of Jesus, I believe God has destined me to be somebody. I believe it's the will of God to get married, to have houses, to have the blessing of the Lord, and I will get there. So now let's go. Let's do some teaching. Now let's read it together, verse 29. For whom he did what foreknow, he also did what predestined. So there are two words. The first one said those whom he also know. Right? And what did he do? He did what? He predestined them to be what? Conformed to the image of his son, that he may be what? The first among many brethren. So first of all, have to know you. Know what you're going to be. So what did he do? He predestined you. That means before you were born, he has already seen what you're going to be. Right? Right. So he predestined me to be what? To be conformed to the image of son, so that I can be like God, like Jesus Christ. But see, that's what he predestined me to do. But see, my getting to be like God, getting to be like Jesus is going to be tied to me. Please, I want you to listen very well. This message will help you get there quickly than ever before. Do you understand now? Do you understand? David, come and sit here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How many seed do you pass? You should not even notice. So, okay. See, you are sitting at the front, right? So you pass how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You pass what? 6. No, he was sitting, he was 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, that means he jumped from that place to here. How did that happen? Because what? He moved. But if he refused to move, where will he be? Only one person get it. I don't think you understand it. I'm saying this because, please, I'm going to give you vital information that will change your life. Please, what is it? Yes. But he's been sitting there. Do you understand now? This is where he's supposed to be. But when I found him, he's at that place. Do you get it now? This is his destination. But look at where he is right now. Waiting for miracle to happen. A miracle does not happen until he moves to this place. I'm going to give you some information that will help you. Now, if I say move, you refuse to move, where will it be, sir? So you're going to see be what? In the same way, spot. So now, sit down. Let me teach you something now. Now, everybody give me attention right now. I'm going to give you a couple of things that are responsible for you getting faster and then delay. So in the scripture here, it says, for whom he did what? For known. That means he know about me already. Yes, yes. Not only that, he also predestined me. That means to be conformed to the son that I am a being. So that means he has already put everything in my way to get me there. So can I ask you a question? Can someone answer me? What are those things he has put in my way to get me to where I'm supposed to go? Okay. Okay. I want to, you see, I don't want to preach to you. I want to help you understand. Two words. He foreknow me. Second word, why? He predestined me. So, he's already done it. But, you see, the problem is not God. The problem is me. So, let me give you one of the things that you need in life that will get you into your future quickly. Write it down. It's called information. That's why most of you don't care. Or you call it what? Knowledge. With that knowledge, you can never move. God have destined you to be married. God have destined to be somebody in life. But if you are not properly informed about your destiny, you will never take a move in life. So that's why coming to church is very important. Tuesdays, Friday, every Sunday, because one information can move you. So the Bible says, my people are destroyed because of what? Lack of knowledge, not because of the devil. So I was just talking to my resident pastor in Atlanta. We begin to talk. I said, some people are really daft. You know, there are a group of people right now in America and here in London who they call themselves black Jew. Black. Jewish black. They said they want to be the heritage of the Jewish people. Here in London and America, the ones who are black Jewish people. So they believe they want to be like the Israelite. Have you not seen people? Okay. Yeah, no. So this is what they are designing. And they are doing everything to get there. How stupid and dumb they are. Because why? The Bible tells them, Colossians, why? In the sight of God, there's no brown, there's no black. All of us are already Jewish in spirit. You see, spiritual control the physical. To them, they want to be physical Jew. Already I'm a Jew. I'm a Hebrew already because of Abraham. So why am I trying to fight? Say, I want to be a black Jewish guy. I am a old Jew already. Why? The Bible says so. But because they don't know, they are fighting to become who they already are. One of the reasons why Satan was able to succeed to deceive our grandmother called Eve, because why? She was stupid. The devil came to her and said, hey, Eve, you know what? If you eat this fruit, you'll be like God. Because she doesn't know who she was excited. You mean, I'm going to be like God. And that was why she missed it. Unknowing to what, she's already what God. She was created what? In the image of God. But because she was stupid. I've seen people do a lot of things in the name of, I want to be who you already are. Our joy is because I'm going to be like God. Man, you are God already. You are created in the image of God. Why are you trying to be who you are? Lack of knowledge. So when I look at people, even when I hear prayer point, I will tell that this person, I see people go to the mountain to get anointing, to get power. Why the Bible say in the book of Acts 1 verse 8 say, you shall receive what? Power when the Holy Ghost shall come upon you. And they got the Holy Ghost. But I see this is what? Power. Lack of what? Knowledge. So the point I'm saying, your destiny has been predestined already, but you are getting there. It's that to how much knowledge do you have? And how much light do you have? Not how much prayer you prayed. Light. How much light you carry. So when I talk to people, they say, let's pray. But you don't even have knowledge at all. And you don't even care. The secular people, hungry for knowledge. They buy books. But you have never bought books in your life. So you want to be, you are expecting magic. I'm telling you why there's a delay. Some will get there at the age of 30. Some will get there at the age of 50. Because what? They are not seeking knowledge. They are not seeking relevant knowledge. I have been destined to be somebody in life. That is the truth. That is a fact. But my path is to find out information. For information, if you are driving here to Hackney, there are two ways you can get there. Either through Blackwood Tunnel, or Rotherhithe, or London Tower Bridge. But let's say you only know Blackwood Tunnel. And Blackwood Tunnel is blocked. Do you know you're going to see, you miss the journey? Because why? You have no idea there's a Rotherhithe Tunnel. You have no idea you have Tower Bridge, right? But because you don't know, you die. Knowledge is what you need in life. Know how many fasting you pray. You are destined to be great in life, but you're not seeking for knowledge. When I deal with people who are so ignorant, it pains my heart because when people say something, I say, can you open the Bible? Because some of the scripture you are saying, you don't even know the interpretation. You say, but the Bible says so, but who is the Bible talking to? Is it you? So the scripture are written to the Jewish people. You are claiming it. Jesus was not a Christian. If you don't know that, he was Jew. Jewish guy. That's why he went to the synagogue. We don't go to the synagogue. The Bible says, as his custom was, he went to the synagogue all the time. Why am I saying that? There's so many things we're trying to claim, or it's not relevant for you now. You are destined to be somebody in life, but how quickly you're going to get there is tied to what you are doing. Say, Lord, help me to seek relevant knowledge so I can get to my prophetic destiny quickly. So do we understand now? So let's categorize the three, please. Aeroplane take you faster to your destination, right? Do we agree? A car take you also faster to your destination, right? Then your food can also take you there. So the two choices is either aeroplane or car. So how do you get those two things? All of them is knowledge. Do you know, let me understand. Do you know that if you live in Europe, you can pay £1 to get what they call air, £1 can take you to Scotland. But we don't know that. There are mega bus that you can pay £1. Do you understand? Can take you there. But if you don't know, you're going to spend 1,000. Because why? You are not properly taught. Today, every veil of ignorance in your eye, I break it in the name of Jesus. I say, I break it in the name of Jesus. The level of the light you carry is how fast you go. That means whatever it costs you to spend on knowledge, information, men, go for it. Because it will help to get you quickly than anybody. Do you understand now? God wants you to get your prophetic destiny. But the devil will never allow you to get knowledge. Knowledge is all you need. That's the number one thing. Before you get to anywhere, ask question. What is the best way? What's the best route? Do you know now, those who drive car have different meter. If they have a traffic here, do you know because they have knowledge, they'll take a different route. But there are some people that they will stay in the traffic and miss their appointment. Why? Because they are not knowledgeable. They are not knowledgeable because why? They don't know. So the major thing that is making some people get late to their destiny is lack of knowledge. They are holy. They are pure. They are prayer warrior. They are sanctified. But they are stupid in their mind. So that's why when I see people who are hungry for knowledge, I respect them. Most of my sons and daughters who ask questions, I know they want. Some people will never ask. Pride. You don't know it. Write on somebody who have gone far. Write on somebody's shoulder who have been there before you. Don't say, I'm going to go. You're going to have a lot of casualty. Knowledge. Because what you think you know may be wrong. So the first thing you need in life to get into where God has destined to be, find out. Find out. Get knowledge. Do you understand now? So here now, God know about me. Not only that, he has destined me to be what? To be confirmed to be what? No, look at it. To be what? So that means in his mindset, he want me to be like Jesus. But up to now, I am still praying to be like Jesus. I don't think you understand. I'm talking to the wrong people. He destined me to be what? Confirm what? To the image what? That's what he destined me to be. That means in his mind, that's who I am. But I'm not there yet. Why? Because what? I have not found out information to get there. May God give you light. I say, may God give you light. I say, may God give you light. I say, may God give you light. You'll get there faster than anybody in the name of Jesus. So the first thing I need in life, knowledge. Every share knowledge, information will help me get to my prophetic destiny faster. Everything you're looking for now is already done. Whatever you're looking for is already done. Say in the name of Jesus, whatever God has destined me, I will get there. I'll get every information, every knowledge that will get me there. Every spirit of laziness that will stop me from getting knowledge, I come against it in the name of Jesus. I say, I come against it in the name of Jesus. I say, I come against it in the name of Jesus. I come against it in the name of Jesus. I come against it in the name of Jesus. So I'm destined to be like Jesus, right? Right? But how do I know? I must find out. Can I ask you a question, man? Stand up. If somebody paid £5 million into the bank or open a bank account with your name and put £5 million there in your name, but you do not know about it, tell me the kind of life you will live. You will live a poor life, right? Hello? You live poor. Because what? You do not know that there's a $5 million on your account for you. So already it's been done. That means the same thing, everything you're going to be in life, God has already given you. May you find out today. I said, may you find out today. I said, may you find out. Whatever you want to know, you're going to find out what God has given to you, and you'll get there in Jesus' name. Whatever you want to know, you're going to find out what God has given to you, and you'll get there in Jesus' name. That's why when you come to church like that, some, you know, right now they say it's cold. Some people can't come because you go, if you're not coming here, what will help you with more than staying at home? You're going to be here. The devil will tell you it's cold. Go to Russia and say, cold. Minus 50. What would he say? Go to Siberia. But people are going now. Do you get the point now? So what am I telling you? You've been destined to be great in life. Say amen. It's the will of God. You should be somebody in life. Say amen. God has destined you to be anybody in life. But you can't become them without getting the information about your future. Where do you get information? When you go to church. Where do you get information? When you study the word of God. We're getting what? The more knowledge of the word of God you begin to receive, that's why you are getting what? Information about your destiny. Because you are supposed to be conformed to the image of the Son of God, but you are not there. You say, but I'm not like Christ, but you are. You're already there. Said to me, I must find out, okay, why am I not living like Christ? It's because there's something I'm lacking. Stand up, man. Are you a man or a woman? A woman. Okay. If you pray in the next 1 hour to be like a woman, will you be like a woman? You already were a woman, right? But do you know some people ask prayers, some prayer that they are already who they are? Can God answer that prayer? So tonight, I open your understanding to get to that journey of your life in Jesus' name. So do we understand? What's the first thing you need in life? Knowledge. Everybody shout knowledge. Shout it. Shout it. Where do you get knowledge? Through the word of God. Whatever you got to do to get knowledge, get it. Get knowledge, get understanding. That's all you need. It will even change your prayer points. Because you've been destined. Not only that, God know who I am, but he also predestined me to be conformed to the image of his Son. So that means I'm destined. In the mind of God, he want me to look exactly like Jesus. He want me to talk like Jesus, walk like Jesus, cast a devil like Jesus, do everything that Jesus is going to do. That's what he has planned, right? But it can never happen until I get information. How will I function like Jesus? How will I talk like Jesus? How will I cast a devil? I'm the one that need to find out. Tonight you're going to find out. Tonight light will come to you in Jesus' name. I said light will come to you in Jesus' name. I said light will come to you in Jesus' name. Our grandmother lost it because why? She did not know she's already God. And because of that, the devil gave. See, do you know not everybody the devil tempt? No. Some people the devil will not tempt them. Because whatever, ma'am, can the devil tempt you to steal $1? Can the devil tempt you to steal £5? You know you can't do it, right? He can't come. So if you're getting too much temptation, it's because the devil knows that you are ignorant. Oh, I don't even understand. Can the devil tempt you to slap her? If he tempts you, will he do that? No, because you know you can't do it. So if the devil is coming one area because what? You know that you don't know. Oh, I don't understand. There's some area the devil can't tempt me. Because you know that I'm bigger than that, I can't do it. But if you know you're weak in that area, you come in that area. So if the more knowledge you get, the more the devil will avoid coming around because what? You can't do it. You can't tell me to slap somebody. I can't, because it will never happen. Because I know beyond that. Two wrong can never make a right. Do you get the point now? So what is the first thing you need? What? Knowledge. Everybody say knowledge is what I need in life to get to my prophetic destiny. Knowledge of what the Bible say about me, that is what will take me there. And I release that upon you in Jesus' name. Alright, number two. Let's go to verse 20, verse 30. Because I want to show you, because you're destined to be somebody, you're destined to be rewarded already, but you don't even know. In verse 30, it said, moreover, whom he did what? Predestinate. Them he also what? Called. And whom he what? Called. Them he also what? Justified. And whom what? He justified. Then he also what? Glorified. There are two things I want to talk before we close. So now look, every look up. The first one, he destined to be like Jesus. He's not wishing. He has destined to be like him. Right? So now, my job is to find out, am I like Jesus? What will I do to talk like Jesus? Do you understand why? So I need to find out, get information. Now, in here, number two here, he said, moreover, whom he did was predestined. I mean, before I was born, in my mother womb, he predestined me also. And what do you want? He has what? Call. If you look at the call now, it's in the past tense. That means he called me before I even got saved. Everybody say, I am called. Shout it. Shout it. Say, God called me. So I don't even understand. I'm trying to give you understanding. So here he has already called me. So if he has called me, why have I not answered the call? Because why? I do not know he called me. He has called you to be rich. He has called you to be a millionaire. He has called you to be a billionaire. He has called you to win soul. So but I must know. God has called me to do his will, to do his purpose, and I will do it, and nothing can stop me in the name of Jesus. Say, I am called. Say, I am called to do the work of God, and I will do what God has called me. How many of you are called? Shout it, I'm called. Say, God has called me to do his work, and nothing can stop me. Lift up your right hand. Say, Father, as I lift up my hand, I believe, I declare, I am called. No power, no spirit can stop my calling in the name of Jesus. So that should be your prayer every day. I am called, I'm called, I'm called. The devil can't stop me. I am called, I'm called. Right? Okay, that's number two. Number three, say, on whom he also called, then he also was justified. If you look at the justifier now, it's in the past tense. What does the word justify mean? It means that you are clean without fault. I don't understand. That means you have never had error. When I say you are justified, I say everything about you are is clean. But see, you be justified, but you are living condemned life. No, have you not seen people who are justified living condemned? Yeah, they live as if they are condemned criminal. That means whatever you have done before now, the moment you are in Christ Jesus, he justifies you from all your mistakes. In the sight of God, there's no record. To be justified, that means he has cleared everything that is in your record. Say amen. I say he has cleared everything that is in your record. Say in the name of Jesus, everything that is in my record has been clear. So if it's clear them, my life is supposed to be the life of our joy, excitement. Today, every voice of guilt, I come against in Jesus' name. I say, I come against in Jesus' name. I come against in Jesus' name. I come against in Jesus' name. Shout, say, I am justified. Nobody will condemn me. Stand on your feet. Stand on your feet. We're going to pray a prayer. Because some of you are not acting. The way you are looking, it doesn't show me you are justified. Is everything clear? Say, I'm justified. Every voice of condemnation, I come against it. Open the mouth, begin to pray. Please pray. Pray, say, I come against it.
Now there is no condemnation.
Every voice of guilt, I come against it in the name of Jesus.
There is no record.
I'm justified.
I'm declared free. I'm declared free of the guilt of sin. I thank you, Lord. Now there is no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Jesus. Because he's free. Because you deserve it. He's free. I thank you, Lord. I find the blood of Jesus. I thank you for your blood. I thank you, Lord. Because there's no record.
Justified. But there are people who are justified, but I see asking God to forgive them for the abortion they did 10 years ago. Have you seen people like that? When you are justified, that means you are justified. No record. Now, I think Hebrews 8, right, says, Hebrews 8, so I don't hear 9, but it says, the new covenant, it says, your sin have our forgive. And why I will remember no more. So if God says he will not remember, that means there's no record like that. But see, but people are still bringing the record before you. Or the devil is bringing the record before you. To be justified, that means it's remain clean. To be justified, that means everything around you has been removed. Look at what Hebrews 8, verse 12 say, he said, for I will be merciful to their unrighteousness and their sins and their iniquity I will remember no more. That means he said he doesn't remember no more. That means you are justified. But if you don't know this, you will live the life of the past. You will live the life of regrets. You believe that God did not forgive you. You believe that God is haunting you. Am I having somebody? You believe that God is looking, your mistake is still haunting you. That is the people who don't know that justified. But so start in your mind, I come against in the name of Jesus. I say, I come against you in the name of Jesus, God. I'm taking you somewhere before I land. Are you justified? But don't you know that sometimes when you're by yourself, thought come into your mind of something you've done stupid? Sometimes when you're suffering, you think because of what you've done wrong, right? Does it happen? Because why? You don't know you are justified. That's why light come. Because if you don't know, you're going to live a guilt-free life. If say you are justified, that means I don't have a record. Do you understand now? So it's because of my sin, has he forgiven me? And he will remember no more. But why are people telling you 1932, 1902, what you have done is the reason why you're suffering? Have you heard a preacher preach like that? Because the sin. Hello. The sin you did 2 years ago or this year is the reason why you're not succeeding. Please, have you heard that? So, justify me. I am clean. Shout it. I said, shout it. I don't have no record. Check whether anybody have a question. If those who don't, religious people don't understand, check. So, and the people that will confront you are religious people. Tell you, but the Bible says I'm justified. Before I even commit sin, it justified me. 2,000 years ago. Do you understand now? So now let's go back to the same scripture. Let's go back to Romans 30. 8 verse 30. So I want to show something. And then I'll go to the last part of it. And see what the enemy can do with your life. He said, moreover, whom he did what presented, he also what called, and whom he called them, he also what justified, right? And look at the last thing. He said, whom he justified them, he also what glorified. The glorify is in the past. He has already what glorified me. So but you know what happened? Most of you, you're still praying for God's glory to come upon your life. When what? He has what? Glorify me. So, but if I pray for God to glorify me, will God answer that prayer? No. I'm glorified. I am beautiful. I am fearfully and wonderfully mean. God has glorified me. He has given me all the pattern to life and godliness. I got it already. My own partner is to begin to live it out. Give me amplify. Tell somebody I'm glorified. Say, God have glorified me. God have put beauty in my life. And that's what he said. And I believe it. And that's the life I'm going to live from today. Because if you don't know you're glorified, you will live like a poor person. You will live as if you're broke. Say, I'm beautiful. I'm lovely. I'm looking sweet. Everything about me is beautiful. Because the Bible says so. Say, I'm glorified. God has glorified me. God has beautified me. Everything about me is beautiful. In the name of Jesus. Say, in the name of Jesus, my future is clear. My future is beautiful. Nothing can stop me being who God wants me to be. In the name of Jesus. Amplify. Eh? Clinton, can you re-amplify?
Praise God. And those whom he thus foreordained.
Those who are?
He thus foreordained.
He thus what?
He foreordained.
Foreordained.
He also called.
He also called.
And those whom he called.
That's who you call.
He also justified.
He also justified.
That is, acquitted, made righteous, putting them into right standing with himself.
So now, acquitted, make righteous.
Putting them into,
putting
right,
the word in
into right standing,
standing
with himself.
So that's what it means to be justified. Can we read it to everybody? Want to go? Why are you putting Amos? But this is Amos here. Okay, let's read together. One to go. And those whom he predestined, he also called. And those whom he called, he also justified. So look at the meaning of justify now. Declare free of guilt of sin. You are free. And those who he justified, he also glorified. That means we to raise them to a heavenly dignitary. That's where you are. That's where you are. But you are allowing people to talk down on you. To glory, I mean, he raised you to the heavenly word dignitary. Give me a message. Say, I'm dignified. Shout it, I'm dignified. Look at what message says. After he made them decision of what his wife, children should be like. Please follow, finish it.
After God made the decision of what his children should be like, he followed it up by calling people by name. After he called them by name, he set them on a solid basis with himself. And then, after getting them established, he stayed with them to the end, gloriously completing what he had begun.
You see now, gloriously what? Completely. Give me a message. New International or New International? Man, you are up there. You're not down. Say, I am up. I'm not down. I say, those you praise, they say he also what call, and those you call, he justify, and he also what glorify. That means you are a dignitary. I say, you are a dignitary. I say, you are a dignitary. Look at what NIT says. And having chosen them, he called them to come to him. And having called them, he gave them right standing with himself. And having given them right standing, he gave them his own glory. He gave them. They say he will give them. I got the glory of God. Say, I got the glory of God. Say it. Say, I got it. But you see, praying God, make me. You are beautiful. The reason why you don't, because what you are not what being taught. You've been justified. There are three things I show you. The first one was knowledge, right? The second one, you've been called. The second one, the third one, what? Justify. The fourth one, what? You've been glorified. That's who you are. This thing will help you fulfill your prophetic destiny very, very fast if you know them. Right? Now, look at the last thing as we pray. Go to the next verse. And then look at this. The next verse say,
what shall we then say to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us?
Okay, so that's a question. That means if you don't know those things, you have a lot of things that can be against you. The devil will tell you are not beautiful. The devil will tell you are not justified. The devil will tell you still have a problem. The devil will accuse you. How am I helping somebody? Then after he read, he said, what shall we say there to those things? Which things? The things we just read. How don't you understand? He gave you from verse about five things, right? He said, what can we say of those things? The five things I gave you are, because those things can haunt you in life. Those things can block you in life if you don't know them. Then his father says, what shall we say of those things. I mean, the pig will reign. If God be for us, who can be? That means he's telling that if God says you are justified, you are glorified, you are called, it doesn't matter what anybody can say. Let them be against you, it will not hold ground. Amen. Do you get the point now? If God be for me, every knowledge of the enemy, it will not work. So that means these are the things I need to help me fulfill my prophetic destiny. I am called. Number two, I'm justified. Number three, I am already being glorified. So that means I need to walk in God's capacity. Then, when the enemy tried to talk to me, I answered the enemy, if God be for me. To be for me, I mean, if God is on my side, if God approves of me, it doesn't matter who is against me. So that means that will be your answer to the enemy. Because why? You are destined to be rewarded this month. Stand on your feet. Say, I am destined to be rewarded this month.
This month.
There's nothing.
There's nothing
the devil can do about
the
it.
The devil can do about
it. I don't care.
I don't care
what the devil can do.
What the devil can do.
And then he said in verse 32, he said, if look at verse 32, then we're going to pray. Because I believe somebody here will lift you up free. Say, he that spare not his son, but deliver him up for us all. How shall he not with him also freely give us what? All things. So child of God, if God can give you Jesus to suffer for you, there's nothing he cannot give you. So that means your dreams will come to pass. Your dream will come to pass.
Amen.
I say your dream will come to pass.
Amen.
I say your dream will come to pass.
Amen.
Your desire will come to pass.
Amen.
God will reward you this morning.
Amen.
Everything you are trusting God for, it's happening.
I receive it.
Open your mouth, begin to declare.
I receive it.
I receive it.
Supernatural reward.
I receive it. I am called of God. Declare I am justified. If God be for me, I don't care what the enemy is doing. I am called of God. I am destined to be like the Son of God. I am predestined the enemy can do. I trust the Father. I am believing the Son of God. 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 I am believing the In Jesus' name. Amen. Now, this is a prayer I wanted to pray. In verse 31, this is what the verse 31 asks a question. Can I go to 31? 31 say, open it, let me show you. Because I want us to have a right knowledge. He say, what shall we say wa? Of this wa thing. Do you see the word things there? So what are the things? I give you five things. No, knowledge is not part of it.
Predestination.
Listen. I give you five things. See, it's number one, he foreknow, right?
Yes.
Let me go know about me before I was born. That's number one, right?
Yes.
Number two, not apart from that, he also predestined me to be what? Conformed to be like his son. Do you understand? And that means, in the mind of God, I am just like Jesus. Hello? That's what he predestined me to be. He know about me. And then he predestined me, right? That's number two, right? And then number three, he called me to be a millionaire. To be a billionaire.
Yes.
To be what he want me to be. So that means I am already what? Called. That's number what? That's number what?
Number three.
That's number one, number two, comma. And then number four, what did he do? He has justified me. He has declared me no sin. He has declared me everything about my life is clear. I'm in this right position with him. Do you understand now? Listen to what I'm saying now. That's number four. And number five, what has he done? He has what? Glorified me. So that means he took me from a place of mediocrity and bring me to a place of power. Do you get now? So this thing has been settled from God's side. Then he came to 31 and said, what shall we say of those things? Which thing? These five things I give to you. Why is he saying that? Then he said, but if God be for us, who can be again? You know what it means? He's saying that the devil will tell you you are not called. I don't understand. The devil will tell you you are not justified. Or human being. We tell you there's nothing good about you. Oh my God. Oh, human will tell you you are not righteous. Do you get that? So he's saying that if God said this is who I am, he's saying that if anyone that will try to raise anything, those things I show you, right? You are supposed to condemn them. So the last prayer you're going to pray now. The Bible says, every tongue that raises against me in judgment shall be condemned. So you're going to speak again. Every human accusation, every mind accusation, every past accusation,
yes,
I come against it in the name of open the mouth, begin to pray. Every voice, that raised against me in judgment from me, from my conscience, I come against it. You are the one that can come against it. Every imagination, every people are saying about you, I condemn it. It will not stand, it will never come to pass. Condemn every voice of people. Condemn every voice of man or woman or spirit. Every voice in your mouth. Condemn the voice of guilt. Condemn the voice in your imagination. Condemn the voice of the
past.
It is God that just condemned the voice of guilt. Condemned the imagination of guilt. Condemned the thought. Everything people are saying about you. Reject it. It's not my voice. I said no.
Against me. It will come to pass. In the name of Jesus.
Amen. Yes, Lord. Now look at. Look at verse 33. I want you to pray. Verse 33. He said, who shall lay what? Anything.
A charge.
To the charge of God elect. It is God who are just what? Do you know there are people who believe that you will never make heaven? I don't think you understand. They have the charge about your past. They've charged you already. That the woman with the issue, with the woman that was caught in adultery. Jesus said, where is the accuser? He said, my daughter, go and say no more. I don't condemn you. So that means it's possible people can lay a charge on your past and use it against you. Say, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Any charge. Every allegation.
Any allegation.
Against my name.
Against my destiny.
My integrity. I come against him now. I reject it. I destroy it. I reject 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 it. I reject
I am a declarer,
Amen. Put your hand on your head.
Yes, Lord.
Whenever you're watching me, do the same thing. Lord, I stand on this altar. I speak over these people here and those who are watching me. You've destined them to be great in life. That's what you was. You're destined to be rewarded. But there are allegations, accusations haunting their destiny. I stand here to speak to those allegations. You say, who is it that will let the child again? The elect of God. Every allegation to block them from getting their prophetic destiny or from getting their reward in this month of the world, I destroy those allegations right now in the name of Jesus. I overturn the allegation and I release their prophetic destiny to begin to manifest right now. I release their reward to begin to come from right now. Whatever is destined for them before, even this week, I call it for now by your power. And I challenge the voice of the enemy. And I command them free. Whoever the Son shall say free must be free. Jesus, you've set them free. Therefore, I endorse the liberty, freedom for the people of God right now. Everybody shout, I am justified. I am glorified. Every accusation is canceled. Oh, shout of joy. I said, I receive my freedom. I see my freedom. I see my freedom. I receive my freedom. It is done by the Spirit in Jesus' name. Whenever you're watching me, I believe you're destined to be somebody in life. Believe me, nobody can stop them. You will enter into your prophetic destiny. This is the month of reward. Get ready. Wherever I saw you is coming. And nothing can stop you. You will testify. You will finish the year beautifully. You will not die premature. Everything God wants for you this year is coming to pass. Receive it now wherever you're watching me. In Jesus' name. But if you are not saved, you can get saved right now. All you need is to call Jesus into your life. Just say, Jesus, come into my life and be my Lord and Savior. I believe in you that you are the Son of God. Thank you, Lord. I'm saved in Jesus' name. If you pray that, it is done and nothing can stop you. I'm going to see you again on Friday. You're going to have a testimony. God bless you. Amen.